In these valleys, farther from the sea than anywhere else on Earth, dinosaurs walked. They laid eggs, they raised their young, they lived their lives. And here, in China's Gobi Desert, they died their mysterious deaths. Inside these layers of ancient sediment are clues to one of our great mysteries, the day-to-day existence of the most dramatic animals the world has ever known. Once masters of the planet, they have been entombed for an eternity in this forbidding and unforgiving land. Primordial dragons, locked in stone for over 100 million years. There have been many quests into the time before humankind, but the farthest-reaching dinosaur hunt in history, known as the Dinosaur Project, started in 1987 with the first stage of a multi-year joint venture between Canada and China. Scientists from the Canadian Museum of Nature in Ottawa, the Royal Kuril Museum of Paleontology in Alberta, and the Chinese Academy of Sciences in Beijing have come in search of the graves of dinosaurs, have come in search of the dragon. They believe that by knowing more about the lives and deaths of the dinosaur, we will gain a fuller understanding of our own beginnings. And so they have set up camp in the inhospitable Gobi, 4 days' walk from the closest village. They will be here for 3 months, here on the edge of nowhere, hunting for dinosaurs.
Looks like you did good. Looks marvelous. Up on that hill over there.
Yeah. Francis!
Oh, you look like you got a tan or something.
You bet.
Ping.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh!
Dale Russell from Ottawa is one of the world's leading dinosaur theoreticians. Some claim he has a clearer vision of dinosaur life than anyone in the history of the science. Even in China, Russell is considered a legend.
Dr. Russell? That's John Brinkman over there.
Another legend is Dong Zhiming, China's foremost dinosaur expert. He has probably found more of their fossils than any living paleontologist. Phil Curry is among the leading dinosaur hunters in North America. He manages the dinosaur research program at the prestigious Royal Kuril Museum. The team consists of 30 Chinese and 10 Canadians. They will spend the next 16 weeks in almost total isolation. Just them, the desert, and the bones of the largest creatures ever to stroll the planet.
I would like to express on behalf of us from Canada our tremendous gratitude for our Chinese colleagues for allowing us to come here and to carry out a dream that we've always wanted to do, to work in the Gobi of northwestern China, where fossils are found in such abundance, and we look forward to finding excellent specimens for China. Guys, well, him gao sing zai fer, xie xie ni. Let's go get it.
Cheers.
Cheers.
In all the world, there are fewer than 40 full-time dinosaur paleontologists. Three of them are leading this expedition.
Every paleontologist is an individual. There's no question of that. In fact, you could go one step further and say every paleontologist is a character. Dong Jiming is just a superb field man, more concerned with the finding of the specimens, collecting the specimens, and then the description of the specimens. Dale Russell's sort of on the other end of the scale, and he's the thinker of the three of us, and he's the one who develops the ideas. Whereas I would say that Dong Jiming and myself tend to be people who test those ideas more than anything else. So we have basically three levels with the three scientists, and I think it works very, very well together.
For Phil Curry, the trip to the Gobi could be the highlight of a lifetime spent in awe of the dinosaur.
The majority of people who do research in paleontology consider themselves to be detectives in a sense. That part of the joy of our field is being able to go out and put together clues that sometimes are extremely obscure to try and understand not only who the body is that you're dealing with, but what was the nature of that animal's death, and take it even one step beyond that and try and understand what that animal was like when it was alive. Paleontologists, I think, would love to have a time machine that would just take them back so that they could look at these animals they were studying to know how right or wrong you are.
If fossils are to be found here, they will probably be discovered on the edge of the cliffs where eons of erosion have exposed rock laid down in the dinosaur age.
I have seen the sedimentary remains of the age of dinosaurs on four continents, and I have never seen anything, any of them, as beautiful as this.
We feel that this part of China at least has the same potential as the proven resources in both Alberta and Mongolia, and consequently there's a little bit of a risk-taking involved in this particular thing, but I think the chances of a very high yield are very, very promising.
To fossilize, an animal must be buried quickly in mud or sand before the bones begin to decompose. Then, over many centuries, minerals seep in and replace the bone, producing a fossil hard as rock. The odds of this happening are so slim they are impossible to calculate. But then on top of that, to actually find the fossil makes the world of the dinosaur hunter the world of the long shot.
Dinosaur hunting is probably one of the most rewarding fields I think anybody could be in. Here you're doing something that you dreamed about doing when you were a child. Number one, it's outdoors most of the time. You've got this sense of discovery. You're looking for clues. There's a lot of hard work involved. But when you've been at it for a while, you develop a search image, and it's automatic. You can be walking along thinking about something on the other side of the world entirely, and your eyes will catch just a glint of bone or just the right shape in the rock, and suddenly it fires something in your head, and you shut out everything else you've been thinking about, and then you focus on that piece of bone.